In this screencast, we're going to look at a sphere in crossflow and compare the heat transfer from that sphere using two different fluids, one water and the other air. And we're going to use the same correlation for both situations since there's only one correlation that's generally used, and this is known as the Whitaker correlation. So if you take a look, we're going to have a sphere that's going to be dropped into two fluids, both at the same temperature, T infinity, that's equal to 20 degrees C. And what we want to use is Newton's law of cooling, as shown right here, to find that surface temperature. So we rewrite that the surface temperature is equal to the heat transfer divided by the convective heat transfer coefficient times the surface area plus our T infinity. So we looked up all these properties at T infinity, which for the correlation is needed, except for we had to find this dynamic viscosity at the surface. So since we don't have a surface temperature to look up our viscosities at the surface, I had to guess at each one and look up that viscosity appropriately. So I assumed that the water was a good medium for heat transfer, and so I thought that the surface temperature would be about 30 degrees. So I looked up that. However, for the air, I assumed a considerably higher temperature. In fact, I looked it up at 500 degrees C. And so now what our plan is that we will calculate the Nusselt number using the correlation above. And from that, we can get our H bar, or our heat transfer coefficient, because that's equal to the Nusselt number times the thermal conductivity of the medium divided by the diameter. So in this case, we're going to assume that the diameter stays the same. So the diameter of our sphere is going to be equal to 0.075 meters. And we're also going to assume that the heat transfer from the sphere is going to be equal to 300 watts. So we'll start by calculating the Reynolds number first for water and then for air. So our Reynolds number, which is equal to the velocity times the diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. When we figure it out for air, our Reynolds number is equal to 9,927. When we figure it out for water, our Reynolds number is equal to 3.735 times 10 to the fourth. And so now let's go back to our correlation. And if you notice, everything here is a function of Reynolds or the Prandtl number, except for that ratio of the viscosity of the bulk divided by the viscosity of the surface. So we're going to calculate that based on our Reynolds number for both the water and the air. So when we find the Nusselt number for the air, that's going to be equal to 50.6. When we find the Nusselt number for the water, that's going to be equal to 334.8. So you can see already the large difference in our Nusselt numbers because of the different properties of our fluids. Now, based on our previous equation, we're going to calculate our heat transfer coefficients. So when we find it for the air, it's equal to 17.3. When we find it, however, for the water, this heat transfer coefficient is much larger, and in fact, it's 2,678. Finally, we're going to find our surface temperature. So we'll start with the surface temperature of the air, which is equal to that 300 watts divided by our h bar times the area, the surface area of the sphere, plus our 20 degrees C. And that's going to be equal to, actually even higher than I guessed, it's going to be equal to about 1,000 degrees Celsius. If we find it for the water, however, and we do the exact same thing, and remember that our H bar for our water is considerably higher, and we add 20 degrees C to that, you'll find that that's equal to 47.3 degrees C. So this shows that the choice of medium is extremely important when you're looking at dissipating heat.